Hi friends, today I have taken up percentages topic and here I am going to explain you the tricks, shortcuts and formula in percentages. Okay, let's move on to the first formula. To express fraction into percentage, multiply the fraction with 100. Okay, to express fraction into percentage, multiply the fraction with 100. Suppose consider 1 by 2 is the fraction. To express this into percentage, we need to multiply this with 100. 1 by 2 into 100 gives 50%. 250 is 100, so 50%. And similarly, to express percentage into fraction, divide the percentage with 100. I repeat, to express percentage into fraction, divide the percentage with 100. Suppose consider 50% itself. Now to convert this into fraction, we need to divide this 50 with 100. 50 by 100 gives 1 by 2. 51 is 52. Okay. So 50% is equal to 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 is equal to 50%. The very simple method is whenever you see percentage symbol, just write into 1 by 100. Okay, divide by 100. Percentage symbol is there, no? So you just write by 100. If you won't see any percentage symbol, you just multiply with 100. This gives the desired result for you. Okay, remember that to convert fraction into percentage, you need to multiply with 100, and to convert percentage into fraction, you need to multiply divide with 100. Okay. The third formula is percentage increase or decrease or change or error is equal to increase or decrease or change or error divided by initial value into 100. This formula is used to find the percentage increase or percentage decrease or percentage change or percentage error of any value. Okay. The formula is percentage of increase or decrease or change or error is equal to the increase or decrease or change or error value divided by initial value into 100. Let us consider an example. 50 is incremented by 2, then it becomes 52, right? Now we need to find out what is the percentage increase. Okay, percentage increase formula is increase by initial value into 100. Initial value is 50. Okay, they have given, and the increment which we made is 2. As per the formula, percentage increase is equal to increased value is 2 divided by initial value is 50 into 100. 51 is 52, 22 is 4. So 4% is the increment. Okay, this is very simple. Just write down the increment or decrement or change or error value divided by initial value into 100. This gives the required percentage increase or percentage decrease or percentage change or percentage error. Okay. The fourth formula is if A is more than B by R percent, then B is less than A by 100 into R by 100 plus R. And the fifth one is if A is less than B by R percent, then B is more than A by 100 into R by 100 minus R. See, you compare both the formulas, it is same in the numerator and denominator, that is 100 and R values are there. Okay, in both numerator and denominator for both the formulas. Okay, and in the numerator you can see 100 into R, 100 into R is common. Okay, now how to remember the denominator? It is very simple. In the denominator it is 100 plus R because the if condition contains more than statement. Okay, and in the fifth formula you see less than B, that statement is there, no? If A is less than B, that means less always represents minus, so you place minus symbol in the denominator. So using these tricks you can remember this formula. It is very simple. In the numerator you will get 100 into R for both the formulas, and in the denominator it will be either 100 plus R or 100 minus R. In the if condition, if you see more than, then place plus symbol between 100 and R. In the if condition, if we see less than, then you place 100 minus symbol in the denominator between 100 and R. And the sixth formula is, if x percent and y percent are two successive changes, then the overall change is x plus y plus xy by 100%. That is, a number gets changed for twice and those changes are very successive and the values are x percent and y percent. Now the final change, that is the overall change, is x plus y plus xy by 100%. Let me explain this with an example. Consider that 100 is the initial value. It got increased by 10%. 10% of 100 is 10. So 100 plus 10, it is 110. Again, it got increased by 10%. 10% in 110 is 11. So 110 plus 11 is 121. This is the final value. This is the initial value. Let us check the percentage change between the final value and initial value. Percentage change is equal to final value minus initial value, that is the change in the value, by initial value into 100. This formula I already explained you in the third formula, okay, which is that one. Percentage change equal to final value minus initial value by initial value into 100, that is 21 by 100 into 100, that is 21%, okay. Now use this formula and check whether this is correct or not. Here x is 10%, y is 10%. Okay. Substitute these values in this formula. X plus y plus xy by 100. 10 plus 10 plus 10 into 10 by 100. 10 into 10 by 100 is 1. So 10 plus 10 plus 1 is 21%. See here, both the values are same. As of now, both the formulas will work fine. But when there are complex values, then it is very difficult to calculate. So go for this formula. It will be very useful. Not only in percentages, but also in profit and loss, you can use this formula. If x percent and y percent are two successive changes, then the overall change is x plus y plus xy by 100%. The 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th formulas are related to population, increment or decrement. Okay. The 7th formula is, if the population of the town increases by R percent, then the population of the town after N years is present population into 100 plus R by 100 whole power N. And the 8th formula is, if the population of the town decreases by R percent, then the population of the town after N years is present population into 100 minus R by 100 whole power N. And the 9th one is, if the population of the town increases by R percent, then the population of the town N years ago is present population into 100 by 100 plus R whole power N. And the 10th one is, if the population of the town decreases by R percent, then the population of the town N years ago is present population into 100 by 100 minus R whole power N. See here, it is said that so many people are getting confused because of these four formulas. I will give some tricks to remember these formulas. You just follow them. It will be very useful. You see the values in all the four formulas. You can see present population as the first term. Okay, present population. And also one more thing, within the braces whole power N, braces whole power N, braces whole power N, here also the same, braces whole power N. So just write down present population into braces some space whole power N, okay. Present population into some gap whole power N, present population into some gap within the braces whole power N, present population into braces whole power N, okay. And the next thing, how to remember the values within the braces. It is very simple. If they mention after, remember that 100 and R values comes in the numerator. Okay. After means 100 and R values comes in the numerator. If it is mentioned ago, N years ago, 100 or 100 and or will come in the denominator. Okay, in years ago means 100 and or will come in the denominator. Okay, now how to remember the symbol plus or minus? If they say increases by r percent, place plus r. Decreases means minus r. If it is increases, plus r. If it is decreases, minus r. And now you are done with the numerator in here. So in the denominator you just fill 100. Here you are done with denominators, you just fill 100 in the numerators. That's all. It is very simple to remember. You have to write down present population, open the braces and close the braces, whole power n. Okay, you check whether it is after n years or n years ago. If it is after n years, 100 and r will be in the numerator. If it is n years ago, 100 and r will be in the denominator. If it is decreased by r percent, r gets minus symbol. If it is increased by r percent, r gets plus symbol. And after filling the numerator or denominator, you fill the rest of the numerator denominator with 100. And this is how you can remember this formula. Generally this formula, these formulas are used to find the population of a town where after some years or some years ago, depending on the increment happening annually. Okay. Thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel, MyAptiSkills. I'll be uploading more videos. Thank you for your patience. Thank you. I'm really thankful to you for watching this video. I really appreciate your patience for watching this video. If you need any more videos, please subscribe to my channel and start watching my videos. They will be very helpful to you in the long run. Thank you so much once again.